Welcome to leg 3 of our trip in Italy. We embarked from Desenzano to Florence by way of a 2.5 hour train ride. Traveling by train in Italy is incredibly easy and much faster than alternative methods of travel. After spending a few days in the peaceful and quaint town of Limone, we were a bit overwhelmed by the congested crowds in Florence. We arrived before our Airbnb check-in time, and we chose to spend 6 euro to drop off our luggage near the train station so that we could easily walk around the city. There was outdoor seating on a street near the Duomo, where we consumed the Italian staples of pizza, pasta, and spritz. Completely exhausted, we finally made it to our Airbnb in the heart of Florence and crashed for a few hours before hitting the streets again. We walked a short distance to the Accademia di Galleria and got in after waiting only 10 minutes as the lines were a bit shorter in the late afternoon. We spent around 30 minutes browsing the exhibits and got to see Michelangelo's Statue of David. There are plenty of notable sights in Florence, as the city is rich with history and art. We walked laps around the Piazza del Duomo, a massive cathedral which dominates the Florence landscape. Its adjacent baptistry, fashioned with Ghiberti's Gates of Paradise, there is so much to take in Florence. The following morning, we took the opportunity to walk along the Arno River. There is a famous bridge which crosses the river called the Ponte Vecchio. In 1593, Ferdinand I decreed that only jewelers be allowed to have their shops on the bridge, a tradition that still carries on today. We also made an effort to visit the San Lorenzo Market, where several vendors are selling produce, wine, cheese, and we found a delicious snack of bread, honey, walnuts, cheese, apricots, and balsamic vinegar. I'd recommend eating lunch there during your stay in Florence, as there is a cafeteria with diverse eating options on the second floor of the market. Our second day in Florence was planned around a visit to the Uffizi Art Gallery. I read online to devote adequate time for the Uffizi, and I'm glad we did because the collection of art was vast, taking us at least 3.5 hours to walk through all of it. Unfortunately, they did not allow video in the gallery, so instead enjoy this short picture montage of what we saw. Our Airbnb host explained that Florentines leave the city for authentic and better priced food. So we ventured across the river looking for dinner. We stumbled across a wine window, the only functioning one in the city. The wine window operates by simply ringing a bell and being served your choice of wine. They were created in the 17th century for merchants to avoid contact with customers during the plague. We chose to eat at a small restaurant called Al Trinvai. Andrea and I were both in agreement that the steak, the Parmesan chicken, and the spinach dumplings equated to our favorite meal during our time in Italy. It was worth the walk across the river. We finished our time in Florence at the Piazzale Michelangelo, a perfect place to take in the cityscape. There is a neighboring rose garden, which is free to walk through, along with a food and drink stand for those who want to enjoy the natural reprieve from the city. Stay long enough for the sunset and watch the city glow at night. It's a wonderful way to capture the beauty of Florence. Although our stay in Florence was brief, we were glad that we made it fit into our trip. The following morning, we picked up our tiny Fiat rental car to make our journey through the countryside of Tuscany. To follow us for leg 4 of our trip in Tuscany, I'd recommend that you watch the next video. Until then, ciao.
Buonasera, signorina, buonasera. It is time to say goodnight to Napoli. Though it's hard for us to whisper buonasera with that old moon above the Mediterranean Sea. In the morning, signorina, we'll go walking where the mountains help the sun.